Gentlemen, we're going to get finally back into some clean doubles gameplay here. Again, you are watching Defend the North 2019 live from New York City.
Now, I'm actually admittedly not super familiar with Yellow Team here, but I do know Red Team quite well. It's really neat to see Kool-Aid and a New England player, Jen, one of the staples here in New York, really leveled up with this new game, and he's just been doing so consistently
the swole well. Smasher of all time, Kool-Aid.
Oh, oh my God, dude. Right. I'm scared for my life when I fight him in bracket.
Bro, that's like, you know how Wario is like, has like a tummy, but like he also has like some of the biggest muscles you've ever seen in your life?
Oh my God,
he has that, but without the stomach. He's just buff. He's just swole. He's like, oh, what'd you want to counter pick? You want to, but if you got Red Team, we got, again, he's teaming with Gen here. Oh my gosh, all right, here we go. What's the challenge right there? Which is really cool and interesting about the interaction right there is that both of them actually, they would have to commit to a button because both their upbeats don't have hitboxes. So, Mr. Escalator and, K-Love going to be taking that, and Kool-Aid going to be taking the first off here.
Wow, he was at 70. Wow. He's dead?
I mean, that is game frame. Is everyone just, everyone's just losing stocks everywhere and nowhere at the same time. Oh my gosh, boosters.
Red team is seriously down right now. Yeah. They're down two whole stocks.
That was... Oh, okay.
All right, there it is. Now, that's one thing that we're probably going to be seeing a lot from Jen. Jen does play a lot of doubles.
Yeah.
And as Palutena, her up smash is just so good. It's so good because you're like, you know, your teammate doesn't have to worry about like, oh, let me throw them into this precise spot. It's just like this whole thing here, this whole stage, just throw them here. I'll take care of
it.
The
is,
rest.
It is a little on the slower side and does have a little bit of a cooldown, but it does cover a large area. That's kind of the price you got to pay, right? Covers that huge vertical wall, pillar of light. But we're going to see here, actually, one stock down here from the red team. So not too much of a deficit, especially characters, like you were saying, as safe as these two characters, Lucina and Palutena.
At the same time, though, there is like a sort of point of, oh my God.
You're dead.
There is also like a point, like right here, where all of a sudden, every move that the red team makes, every time they mess up, it just matters so much more because they don't have any room to work with.
Yeah.
And then the pressure comes on, and then it's even, like coming back after you've been both brought to your last two stocks is so hard as opposed to, you know, just keeping up with somebody. And a good up smash going to be evening things.
Ooh, that was such a disrespectful throw. That throw. Be gone, peasant. Okay. She is a goddess. Hold on. All right.
I will say, if he's able to survive here, which might be difficult, neither of Yellow Team's characters lack in kill power. Yeah. Right there, the Game & Watch up smash. Palutena might have good hitboxes, but...
Ooh, that was about to be so sick. Okay. Toot toot. Here we go. Toss him out.
Big.
Pass the ball. Pass it again. On today's episode of Can He Land?
That's some great DI from Kool-Aid, actually.
Yeah, you're dead.
Oh,
that was beautiful.
Wow.
Beautiful. Just throw out that hitbox. You trade with the
upbeat. Tiny turt.
Yeah. You throw it out with anything, bro. You're going to trade right there. You're going to get that stock. Game one going over to the yellow team. Good stuff.
That start was just so explosive from the yellow team.
Yeah.
If they're able to do that again, if they're able to repeat that success of just making stocks go away in the first 20 seconds, I think they're going to win this set. That might sound, what's the word, obvious? But I don't know. That felt like it wasn't like some weird, like, oh, man, we got lucky with that. That felt like that was their game mode. It was just boom, out of the gates. You're going to get exploded.
All right, so 2D's it looks like, exploded. Yeah, so it looks like they banned here Lylat as well as Yoshi's Island. So we're going to be heading over to Pokemon Stadium for game number two once again. Okay.
Oh. I will say, I really underestimated like Rob's doubles potential just because both Rob and Game & Watch, their moves stick the opponent in these multi-hits, these long-lasting multi-hits, which gives your partner plenty of time to adjust, to react, to set themselves up to continue the combo. Mm-hmm.
But absolutely. But also, you have to keep in mind that Rob specifically has a lot of moves that take up such a wide. It's just an area of denial. Rob is an area of denial character with top, with the laser heroes, also with the side B. This character is really good at just denying area away from you, specifically at the left shield. Breaker!
Oh my God! Did you see the laser? Yeah. He almost had it, but that was amazing awareness from Kool-Aid. Just being able to avoid that would have ruined everything for him. That stock would have been not his to take anymore. But that is not the timeline we're living in. And now Escalator has lost that stock, and Red Team is the one that started off more explosively this time. Rob is at death's door, 153%. A light breeze from Palo will take it, and a back air will probably do the same.
There we go. Oh my God, that was sick. Good stuff from Escalator. The keys!
Oh, he survived.
Yeah, the directional air dodge. That was incredible use of the mechanic new in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. I mean, not new, but returning in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, that directional air dodge.
I mean, this is the first time Game & Watch can directional air dodge out of his LB.
Yeah, it's true. It's true. That is also true.
Oh, and another stock gone there. I will say, Game & Watch has this, like, eccentric way of comboing. He hits opponents when I think he wouldn't be able to.
Yep.
He manages to find these combos, find these follow-ups in these most...
Yeah.
That
wow, down
he
air.
Comes back from that too.
Good stuff by, oh my God, Jen out here. But unfortunately, he's going to be taking that stock over to Kavilov, excuse me. Here we go.
Oh, man,
turning into a little bit of a 1v1. Okay, get him out. I'm about. Oh, switch dance partners.
Oh, yeah, I like the thought behind that back air. However, Rob's hitboxes are so slow versus both of Red Team's characters that it might have been just a better decision to let me just get back to stage.
Absolutely. Well, watch your shield. Oh, okay. Beautiful pair right there trying to go. And he gets the toss as well. Good stuff. Okay. Created using that short hop nair. Trying to throw out some really large hitboxes, kind of a get off me. The
wow.
chase down with the up air, that was enough. He was too high. That was sick. Oh, okay, noggin. Oh, here we go.
And he pushes him.
Yeah. Sir, let me just, excuse me, sir, excuse me. This is my area, okay? This is my personal space.
Okay? Stay out of my personal
Stay out of
space.
My personal space. Look at this. Watch this. Stay out of my personal space, okay?
You know, you said earlier about Rob and his area of denial, and although I think that can be really good in doubles, in that game, a lot of his area of denial moves take a little bit of time to come
That's
out.
True.
And with the hectic nature, and it felt like there was more of a blitzkrieg from Red Team this time, so I see him doing all of these nairs, and he would get hit for out of these nairs. He would basically, it felt like he did not do nearly as much that game, barring those really clutch edge guards and those sorts of things, but it felt like when things were in a neutral state, Red Team was just running back and forth, being in total control.
Yeah, you need to actually especially in a doubles environment, because you don't have the luxury of resetting neutral whatever you want, like in a game of singles. You need to be able to coordinate with your partner to create the space to throw out the top, to throw out the laser, to be able to create that kind of tempo that you need to be playing that if you decide to play Rob that way. You know, and you don't necessarily have to play Rob that way. Rob, big body character, being able to throw out these large hitboxes as well. So you can play a little bit more aggressive, especially in doubles.
All right, now we're moving in to game three, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so for all of the marbles, winner of this is going to be staying on a winner's bracket, I believe top eight. Winner of this, guaranteed top eight.
Winner's side, and the winner of this actually, I believe, playing Mars and Mr. E here.
Ooh.
So tall tale to, you know, tall mountain to climb right there, but you got to climb the molehill before you get there, and both these guys are trying to ascend here to that top eight. The first top eight here at Defend the North 2019 would be a huge way to start off your weekend.
Oh, yeah. And I will actually say, I think that this would be a pretty big upset for Yellow Team if they managed to take this.
I would agree, just because of the names. You know, Jen, obviously, pretty... Oh, my gosh! Yeah, you're fine. You're
Game & Watch. He managed to dodge the counter right there. That was beautiful. But a down tilt at the ledge, confirming, just is going to take out Cable off stack there.
That up B was so sick. He reverse up B and then landed on the platform because he saw it enter. That was so sick. Toss.
I love the thought behind that, the spin out right there. But good job jumping out. And as a result, he lost that stage control. Yellow Team clearly trying to go for more of these risky plays, which I'm not disagreeing with, but it does mean that inherent in that risk, things can go really south really quickly.
Absolutely,
for them.
But they do have a two-stock lead
here.
Oh, shield!
Again!
Watch this again. Breaker! Okay, there it is. One
and
stock down. Escalator on his last stock.
And just
stock.
A roll behind, just like tapping him on the back as he takes the stock. Just good job, bud.
Ooh, Beyblades! Okay, no. That was close.
What is the official term for that Rob side B? I usually call it the Savage Spit Out. I guess Beyblade is
I mean,
call the top Beyblade sometimes.
I call it whatever, bro. I mean, some nerds gonna tweet at me. It's actually called. I don't. It's a side B, okay? And it does damage and it takes lives here. That's all that matters right now. He's gonna whiff off that one. He's gonna be hitting a few more of those because Jen is still on his first stock here. So you know, 156%. You know, here we go. Toss. Oh. Yeah.
Oh, he actually dodged it. That was great. Baited him into taking his partner's life for him. But yellow team in they're kind of in dire straits right now. Both of their health is in the orange at least, and this is their last stock. Look at this. It's been put at the ledge. Finally, two 1v1 situations might actually be okay for them, considering that it feels like Rob now finally is able to do what he wants when there's not the complete chaos going on. All right, red team taking some risks of their own. That high up B doing all right for him, but that was certainly scary.
You have to take risk on both sides, actually, because you're so far behind. You have to take risk to pick up these stocks, but also you have the luxury to take a bunch of risk if you're red team because you have a stock lead. So it's two same result, but two different mentalities if they both decided to do these. Okay, it's a good toss right there. Playing a little bit of a 1v1 here.
Oh, this could be really big. The top actually saving him? I'm not sure exactly what would have happened right there, but definitely Kamelob is at 151%. Well, both of these guys are dead to anything. Game & Watch is so light. Okay. Shielding that dash attack was huge. Let's see if he can get anything big off of it. Another up B to break out of a bad situation. And somehow both of yellow team are still alive.
Yeah, coast to coast is not going to pick up the kill with any modicum of DI. Oh my gosh, if that was.
Oh, that's going to be it though. They both survive?
Oh, the two count coming in for both of these guys. Can he land? The answer is no. It is up to Escalator. And unfortunately, what goes up must come down. And Kool-Aid and Jen will be taking game number three and advancing the top eight here at Defend the North for doubles.
Yeah, and I really want to just highlight how also that was some good adaptation from Red Team. Compare game one to game two and three. I feel like they just sort of realized the way that their opponents wanted to play. And they're like, but what if we were super-duper aggressive on you?